We're going to leave that story there and take you to Canberra, where the Prime Minister Anthony Albanese and Bill Shorten are responding to the Robodebt findings.
Thanks for joining us. This morning, the government received the final report of the Royal Commission into the Robodebt scheme. The government has publicly released this report as soon as it was tabled this morning and will now carefully consider the recommendations that are presented in the final report. First, I do want to thank the Royal Commissioner, Catherine Holmes, ACSC, and those who assisted her in undertaking this absolutely critical inquiry. I'd like to thank the many hard-working Australian public servants who spent countless hours, days, day and night assisting the Commission to conduct its inquiry. And I particularly want to acknowledge the many thousands of individuals who were harmed by the Robodebt scheme and thank those who bravely shared their stories with the Commission. You ensured the voices of those affected and their families were heard. We have arrived at the truth because of the courage of some of the most vulnerable Australians, people who have shown bravery in the face of injustice, hardship and sometimes terrible grief. The courage stands in stark contrast to those who sought to shift the blame, bury the truth and carry on justifying this shocking harm. The Robodebt scheme was a gross betrayal and a human tragedy. It pursued debt recovery against Australians who in many cases had no debt to pay. It was wrong, it was illegal, it should never have happened and it should never happen again. Under the former Liberal government, this scheme unlawfully raised $1.76 billion in alleged debts against some 526,000 Australians. This tragedy caused stress, anxiety, financial destitution, and sadly had a very real human toll. For more than 4 years, Liberal ministers dismissed or ignored the significant concerns that were raised over and over again, including in the Parliament, but also by victims, by public servants, by community organisations, and of course, legal experts. The Royal Commission has found that the Liberal Party's Robodebt scheme was, to quote, a crude and cruel mechanism, neither fair nor legal, and it made many people feel like criminals. In essence, people were traumatised on the off chance they might owe money. It was a costly failure of public administration in both human and economic terms. There are a range of other quotes that stood out to me when I went through the report in the short time that we've had it this morning. The impact of victims said this on page 342. The scheme was launched in circumstances where little to no regard was had to the individuals and vulnerable cohorts that it would affect. The ill effects of the scheme were varied, extensive, devastating, and continuing. It went on to say, to speak about some of the tragedies, including in a section which is titled Deaths Resulting from the Scheme, which begins at page 337. The Commission heard evidence from the mothers of two young men caught up in the scheme. They gave evidence on their son's behalf because their boys had died by suicide. Their stories are told more in detail below. The Commission is also aware of another tragic death which appears to have resulted from a discrepancy letter issued under the scheme in 2017. The report goes on to say, what is certain is that the scheme was responsible for heartbreak and harm to family members of those who took their own lives because of the despair the scheme caused them. It extends from those recipients who felt that their only option was to take their own life to their family members who must live without them. an extraordinary finding from this Royal Commission. The Royal Commission also goes through very clearly the responsibility and where it lays. On page 177, it says, a particularly mean-spirited aspect of the government's defence of the scheme in 2017 was the employment of the media in a form of counter-attack against criticism, which included singling out recipients who complained. On page 658, it says this, as to whether the Australian government sought to prevent scrutiny of the Robodebt scheme, there is no doubt that there was a constant misrepresentation that the scheme involved no change in the way income was assessed or debts were calculated. When I read that, I recalled the multiple times where we asked questions in the Parliament, and then Prime Minister Morrison responded by saying that there were no changes had occurred, that this somehow went back to the period prior to the change of government that occurred in 2013. It makes it very clear that that isn't the case. It goes through the role of ministers and some key findings. It says on page 106 regarding Scott Morrison and his time as Minister for Social Services, to quote the report, he failed to meet his ministerial responsibility to ensure that Cabinet was properly informed about what the proposal actually entailed and to ensure that it was lawful. With regard to then Minister Tudge, on page 184, it says this, Mr. Tudge's use of information about Social Security recipients in the media to distract from and discourage commentary about the scheme's problems represented an abuse of that power. On page 179, on page 184, it goes through. He knew that at least two people had died by suicide and that their family members had identified the impact of the scheme as a factor in their deaths, but nonetheless failed to undertake a comprehensive review into the scheme, including its fundamental features. On page 158, it goes through then Minister Porter, and it says he could not rationally have been satisfied of the legality of the scheme. Mr. Porter should have at least directed his department to produce to him any legal advice it possessed in respect of the legislative basis of the scheme. He goes on to talk about Stuart Robert and his time as minister in defending the Robodebt scheme. It says, Mr. Robert, then to quote the report, went to quote on page 302, well beyond supporting government policy. He was making statements of fact as to the accuracy of debt, citing statistics which he knew could not be right. Think about that, which he knew could not be right. Nothing compels ministers to knowingly make false statements or statements which they have good reason to suspect are untrue in the course of publicly supporting any decision or program. It then goes through a critique of Mr. Morrison's evidence and says this at page 102. The Commission rejects as untrue Mr. Morrison's evidence that he was told that income averaging as contemplated in the executive minute was an established practice and a foundational way in which DHS worked. An extraordinary comment about a former Prime Minister. It then, on page 302, about Stuart Robert, says this. Mr. Robert was not expounding any legal position and he was going well beyond supporting government policy. He was making statements of fact as to the accuracy of debts, citing statistics which he knew could not be right. On page 315, It says the Commission rejects Mr. Roberts' claim to have acted to end the Robodebt scheme quite as promptly as he professes. Ms. Leon was in fact the first to take steps for that purpose. It goes through in great detail the impact on victims. And on page 342, it goes through very clearly about the ill effects of the scheme were varied, extensive, devastating and continuing. The Commission goes through in enormous detail as well the human impact of the scheme, but it also goes through the economic cost. On page 401, it says this: the Commonwealth incurred estimated total costs of $971.391 million in implementing, administering, suspending, and winding back the scheme, including incidental costs. The net cost of the scheme is approximately $565.195 million, which represents the net impact of its estimated totals of $971.391 million, offset by the estimated savings of $406.196 million. It goes on to say on page 402, the wider costs of the scheme on the broader economy and on society also represent a cost of the scheme. Though real, their measurement is more subjective and has not been attempted in this chapter. The Royal Commission also has, as you will see, a sealed section that has been provided to the appropriate bodies. It says this, just to clarify. I have provided to you an additional chapter of the report which has not been included in the bound report and is sealed. It recommends the referrals of individuals for civil action or criminal prosecution. I recommend that this additional chapter remain sealed and not be tabled with the rest of the report so as not to prejudice the conduct of any future civil action or criminal prosecution. Making that clear as well to preempt perhaps some of the questions that people might ask. That's been provided to appropriate people, not to myself or the minister. I'd ask Minister Shorten to make comments. We'll then be happy to take questions. But I do want to thank the minister for presiding over and being determined as shadow minister first to have the Robodebt Royal Commission. This is precisely why you should have a Royal Commission. For purposes to get to the facts, to expose flaws in the way that government operates so as to ensure that it does never happen again. Minister Shorten.
And that is where we'll leave Prime Minister Anthony Albanese speaking there in Canberra in the wake of the Robodebt report. He has called it a gross betrayal and a human tragedy. And if you or someone you know is struggling to cope, you can contact Lifeline on 13 11 14.